डॉक्टर सतीश कुलकर्णी मैं गैस्ट्रोएंटरोलॉजिस्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग हियर इन मुंबई टुडे वी विल स्पीक अबाउट हेपेटाइटिस बी एंड हेपेटाइटिस सी एंड व्हाई इट इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट हेपेटाइटिस बी एंड हेपेटाइटिस सी आर टू वायरसेस विच लीड टू लिवर डिजीज एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट देम इज दैट दे मे लीड टू क्रॉनिक लिवर डिजीज एंड फर्दर टू लिवर कैंसर एंड मेजर लिवर डिजीज इन द पेशेंट्स विच आर इन्फेक्टेड विद दैम Why are they important and why do we talk so much about hepatitis B and C? Of all the 300 million people in the world who are infected with these viruses, 10% of that load is situated in India alone. So a large majority of patients of hepatitis B and C are located in India. So looking at a major chunk of diseased people who develop subsequent liver disease. How do you get hepatitis B and C? It is not acquired by infected food or water, but are acquired by parental exposure. In the sense, if a mother is hepatitis B positive, she may pass it on to her child at the time of delivery. It can be sexually transmitted. So if we have a spouse who is positive, it may pass on to his wife or husband by sexual means. For those who take intravenous drug abuse, then intravenous drug abuse with sharing of needles is a very common mode of transmission of both these viruses. This is extremely common in the northeastern part of India as well as in Punjab, where intravenous or mainline drug addiction is extremely common. Who should check for hepatitis B? Ideally, every one of us should check our hepatitis B and C status. And those who are not infected obviously should take the vaccine for hepatitis B, which is totally preventable. But those with high risk sexual behavior or anybody who has a positive hepatitis B or C patient in the family should check his hepatitis B and C status. Those who are exposed to invasive procedure like patients of kidney disease who are on dialysis, who need to repeatedly take dialysis during the week as well as the rest of their lifetime, they need to screen themselves for hepatitis B. People who are staying in sanatoria or in groups where they are at increased risk of this infection should also be screened. All health workers should be screened for hepatitis B and hepatitis C. How do you come to know whether your hepatitis B or C positive? Most of the times, patients have no symptoms. So unless you go ahead and test for it, many of these patients don't know that they are infected. Those who do have symptoms may have very non-specific symptoms like lack of appetite, body ache, lethargy, joint pains, which may be attributed to so many other things including stress, lack of exercise and other things. So if you do suspect that somebody has hepatitis B or C infection, they need to go and get a blood test done for these viruses which will detect this infection. Some percent of these patients will come with a proper episode of jaundice. So they will get fever, body ache, nausea, vomiting with high colored urine and then they will notice a yellow sclera. Our aim in treating these patients is to treat them before they develop significant liver disease. So we would love to catch these people when they don't have any symptom. However, even those with symptoms will have to be worked up very rapidly and treatment will have to be considered in appropriate patients. Is there a treatment available for these patients? So definitely yes. With advances in medicine, we can definitely control hepatitis B related liver damage. As opposed to that, in hepatitis C, we can cure it in a significant chunk of our patients. And if a patient of hepatitis C comes to me very early, I would assure a more than 90% cure rate in most of these patients. But unfortunately, most of our patients being ill-informed or investigate themselves only once the symptoms occur, come to us very late, in which case the success rate of therapy is sometimes very low. So earlier a patient comes, a better result we give with therapy, which is why people should be aware of these illnesses and investigate their own hepatitis B and C status so that they can be detected early and they can be treated early. What happens if you don't treat them? Then the liver disease is usually progressive in some of these patients and they will go on to develop deepening jaundice, they will start developing fluid in their abdomen, swelling of the feet. Sometimes they may have vomiting of blood, disorientation. But the worst complication in both these diseases is the development of a liver cancer, in which case treatment options are extremely limited. So the earlier a patient is detected, we can definitely handle this after investigations to prevent all these serious side effects and disease consequences in these patients. What about prevention of these diseases? Obviously, one cannot stress that further that all pregnant women should be checked for hepatitis B and C status so that we can prevent passage of this infection from the mother to the child at birth. So all pregnant women should screen themselves. People with high risk sexual behavior should screen themselves. Safe sex is a very, very essential thing to prevent transmission of both these viruses. Vaccination is definitely available for hepatitis B. Hepatitis B is as dangerous a virus as HIV and can lead to as many disastrous complications as HIV. In fact, it is much more commoner than HIV in the Indian population, and the best part being that it has a vaccine available which can totally prevent hepatitis B infection. So all children who are hepatitis B negative should be vaccinated against hepatitis B to prevent further spread of this disease. And the aim in future would be to achieve a fully vaccinated India where the incidence of hepatitis B would be absolutely zero. So the next target for the government of India should be after polio is hepatitis B eradication from the country by proper vaccination of all the children.